This is Keisha, age 8 and a half. This is Jesse, age 6. This is Sarah, age 8. These children and others like them will try to make you understand what they're talking about on Child's Play. And here is the host of Child's Play, Bill Cullen.
Thank you. You're very nice. Thank you. You were very kind and forgiving, and thank you very kindly. Welcome to Child's Play, a game where children interpret the words that grown-ups try to guess. And by golly, if she isn't back with us again, our current champion so far, she has won $7,300. Make her welcome Suzan Stadner. Welcome back, Suzan. Fourth shot for you, huh? 4 days. This is your fourth. Yeah, this is your fourth day with you.
Okay.
Well, listen, you just be your own sweet self. We'll count the days for you.
Thank you.
What would you like us to know? Wait, what's your husband's name?
Joe.
Is he in the audience?
Yeah, he's the one doing this.
Yeah. That's Joe, old Lefty, we call him. Shall we meet your challenger? Ladies and gentlemen, she is here for her first day, but make her terribly welcome. Her name is Eileen Dear. Hello, Eileen Dear. Puns on that word. What would you like us to know about you, Eileen?
Well, I am a mother of a beautiful little girl who's 5 and a half, Katie Ellen,
uh-huh.
And I'm a professional astrologer, and in my spare time, I like to fly hot air balloons.
In my spare time, I used to fill them. But that's something I shall not get into. Okay, Suzan and Eileen, the very best to both of you. We're going to start the guessing with Suzan, as we usually do, first of all, for home audience and studio audience, here's a word we'll be playing for. Everybody sees this word except our two players. All right, we have to describe this word or interpret it for you. An 8-year-old, name of Jason Long. If you would, please, Jason.
She's nice and she's sweet and, like, if you don't have any lunch money, then she'll probably give you her milk money. And sometimes you go up to her and you say, I like you too, or you go, hi, you're cute. And when you grow up, if they still like you and you're in college, then you like to go off and kiss in places that people will find you.
Isn't that nice? Thank you, Jason. Oh, what a lovely age. Lovely age indeed. My usual admonition, I add it from time to time. Remember, you're listening to descriptions by children. And so saying, your turn, Suzan.
Someone you'd like to kiss might be your girlfriend.
Okay, and not what we were looking for. Made perfect sense. We have now a shot at this for you, Eileen, remembering what you just heard. Adding to it this, from a 5-year-old, name of Kelly Samuel. Kelly.
He's like a prince, and he's really handsome, and he's really rich, and you get married to him, and sometimes he loses his money because he buys so many things for you, and then you say, I don't want to live with you anymore, because he doesn't have that money anymore, and he doesn't look good because he lost all his money and he didn't have new clothes.
That was an entire tragic chapter in Kelly's 5-year-old life. What do you think the one word is we're looking for, Eileen?
Well, somebody who lost all their money. Only thing I can think of is boyfriend.
No? Okay, we have one more interpretation. It's back to you, Suzan. And here with it is one of our regulars. She's pretty good. Her name's Cassie Feldman. She's 7. It's all yours, Cassie.
Well, in the fairy tales, there's a prince, and his last name is this. And he always comes, and he rescues the girl and everything. And he came to Sleeping Beauty, and he came to Cinderella. And all the girls that are nice, and or try to be nice, he
Thank you, like, Cassie. All right, based on that, what's your guess, Suzan?
I think I found mine. Charming.
Charming is the word, absolutely. So you got 1-0 lead. In Cassie's story, that fella got around. Sleeping Beauty, Cinderella, and everybody else. 1-0 is the score. We play Child's Play until time is up. Whoever is ahead at that point wins $500 and a chance at $5,000. We'll be back to pick it up right after this.
What do we have back there for Donna?
A beautiful living room set. It's a beautiful, elegant dining room set.
Beautiful modern furniture.
What do we have behind that curtain?
A new dining room set.
Beautiful patio furniture. Open up the curtain and show her what's back there. You have a beautiful living room set.
Let's make a deal. Burnishing the Fun. Weeknights at 8 on Buzzer. Let's play.
Okay, 1-0 is the score. Let's get set for a new word. This time, Eileen, we begin with you, so you pay close attention. First of all, here for the folks at home, there's the word, and to describe it, a young lady from South Carolina, 8 years old, her name is Molly Turbeville, and if you would, please, Molly.
It's got these big mansions, and it's just beautiful, and it has all these flowers and palm trees, and it's just a real neat place. And these people on the show live there, and they're hillbillies, and they have country ways, and they don't know what a pool is used for, and they bought this big mansion for nothing. If I bought it, I would just learn the ways to run it.
Thank you, Molly. One day you very well might. Based on Molly Turbeville's description, what do you think we're looking for, Eileen?
Well, a place that has lots of mansions and lots of nice things like that would be Beverly Hills.
It would indeed. You're right.
All right.
Well done. All tied up. One for Eileen, one for Suzan. We'll start this one with you, Suzan. Here it is for the people at home and here in the studio. Word's up there. Everybody sees it, but our players. 9-year-old from New York, Terry Ann Bradley. Give us your interpretation of this, please, Terry Ann, dear.
Say someone's picking on my little brother, you know, like just saying, like, they'll start pushing him around because he's smaller than them. And maybe he's the same or she's the same age as me. And I'll come up and I'll go, like, I'll tell them that, you know, they have no right to do that because he's not their property, he's mine.
I'd like to try that a little further, but I shan't. What are we looking for, Suzan?
Well, something you could do to your property is protect it.
No, not what we were looking for. Keep that in mind, Eileen, and listen to this. 6-year-old from Connecticut, Jesse Irwin. Jesse's been with us before. This word, please, Jesse.
It means that, like, it's just a lucky guess, I think. It means that, like, somebody protects you. And he or she is your bodyguard. This is the bad guy. This is you and your bodyguard. Well, this is your bodyguard. This is you. And, well, you better not hurt my friend. If you do, you'll get punched. And then the bad guy hurts me. And then my bodyguard does this.
Thank you, Jesse. That was a brilliant dramatization there. Based on what you heard, what do you think the word is we're looking for, Eileen?
I think your bodyguard would defend you.
Defend is right. Okay. Yes, he did a good job. So did you. Come running back and kick you straight up in the air. It's 2 for Eileen and 1 for Suzan. And we have another word coming up. Here it is for you folks watching. Certainly not there for you folks who aren't watching. Anyway, we're going to start with you, Eileen. First of all, we have a 5-and-a-half-year-old. His name... Her name, certainly. Stacy Moyer. Stacy, dear.
Well, you have to do it real good on your bottom when you take a bath. And you have to do it out here and right. And you have to do it here, and sometimes you might have to do it back there. It's just sometimes fun.
Thank you, Stacy. All right, what do you think the word is, Eileen?
Sounds to me like she's scrubbing behind her ears.
Scrubbing is the right answer. She almost recreated the entire bath syndrome there for us. We're over to you now, Suzanne. You will be the starter, so here for the folks at home is the word. Word's up there, and we have an 8-and-a-half-year-old to describe it for you or interpret it. Name of Edward Hurst. The word, Edward.
It's when you do things that you don't, that you're not sure that it'll work, and you just test them out and you try them out. Like, you can mix acid and radiation and some poison together and see what it does, stuff like that. And that's one of these. I put water and battery acid in a cup one time. They ate the cup.
Thank you, Edward. I always repeat this because I hope you didn't miss it because of the applause. He finished up, so he put water and battery acid in a cup, and it ate the cup, is what he said. Okay, Suzan, what do you think the word is?
It sounds like he likes to experiment.
Experiment's the right answer. You two are doing very well. 3-2 is the score. Eileen, we'll begin with you. Here's for the folks at home and here in the studio is the word we'll be trying for. And here's a 7-year-old, Mark Pribitok. Mark Pribitok, if you would, please, sir.
It's one of the biggest cities in the world. And it's real foggy. They have statues of Greek gods, and they're real nice to their pets. Like, a policeman might stop traffic just for a family of dogs to cross the street.
Thank you, Mark. Oh, marvelous perception. Eileen, what do you think the word is?
Well, one city that I know with a lot of fog is San Francisco.
No, good try. Not what we were looking for. Break for you now. Suzan, hang in there. You could tie it with this one. Same word. Tao Vo is going to describe it. 8 years old. Tao, dear.
It's a place that has a big church and a big watch on the middle, of the, like on the top. And it's a place where, like, all, like, they have a double-decker bus.
Okay. I think, sort of, does that sort of lock it in for you, Suzan?
Yeah, I think he is talking about London.
London is the right answer. It's all tied up. So the score is 3 for Suzan, 3 for Eileen. We'll be back with a fast play round right after this message. Don't go too far away. Hey, it's all tied up. 3 points apiece, so this is going to be it. Now it's time for fast play. From now on, each child will define a different word. As soon as you recognize the word, interrupt with your signal. Each correct answer will be worth 2 points. When you hear the school bell, time is up, and whoever is ahead at that point wins $500 and a chance at $5,000. Both of you now ready to interrupt. Let's see who wins it. Here with the first word, Allison Seidner. Allison.
It's something like sherbet.
What do you think?
Ice cream.
Ice cream's the right answer. Suzan, you're ahead 5-3. Okay, now, ready to interrupt both of you. Next word brought to us by E. Giles Dudley Roby. E. Giles.
It's a kind of bird that's white. The symbol of peace.
That's Suzan again.
Dove.
Dove's right answer. You pull ahead by 4-7-3. Here with the next word is little Eileen Sirioko. Eileen.
Someone who stands behind a counter and you ask for drinks. That person has wine glasses.
Eileen's going to take a chance.
Bartender.
Right. 2 points for you, 7-5. Pretty good. Both of you stand ready now to interrupt the moment you think you know it. Here's John Russo. John?
Everybody dresses up in these on Halloween.
What do you think, Eileen?
Costume.
Costume, right. You've tied the score. 7-7. We have a tie score, and here comes a tiebreaker. Miria Carpenter. Miria.
Well, you can have this. It's like a pipe. It's like a pipe. And he puts soap in and he blows.
What do you think, Eileen?
A bubble pipe.
Bubble pipe's the right answer, and you've got 2 more. The score's 9-7. How do you like that? Here comes the next one as you both stand ready to interrupt. Jennifer Detlefson. Jennifer.
It's like what brides can wear it.
What do you think?
Wedding gown?
No, wrong answer. There's a little bit left to this description now, Eileen. You listen, hear it out, then give us your answer. All right, Jennifer.
And it goes like over your face, and you could, and then when the man kisses the bride, then she lifts it up.
Thank you, Jennifer. What do you think?
That's a veil.
It is a veil indeed, and you have the lead now 11-7. Both of you ready to interrupt? John Siroff with the next one. John.
They grow in Hawaii and they grow on palm trees.
What do you think, Susan?
Coconuts.
Coconuts, the right answer. You pick up two. It's 11-9. Here's the next word, Stacy Condor Curry. Stacy.
It's on the top of your head. And
what do you think, Eileen?
Your hair.
Hair's right. You pick up two. 13-9. Here's the next word, Jennifer Inskeep. Jennifer.
And it's a long, long time. It's not 5 or 10 years. 10.
Susan.
Century.
Right. Good. Good shot. Score 13-11. Next word, Price Samuel. Price.
It could be a goose or it could be a car. And it's a horn. We go just.
What do you think, Eileen?
A honk?
Right. Honk is the right answer. Now it's 15-11. Good. And that's it. Time's up, Eileen. You're a brand new champion. Come on over. What a pump from behind win. Well done indeed.
That's great.
You did a good job. Congratulations. Let me say thank you very much to our very dear friend, Susan. She's become that in these 4 days that you've been with us. We thank you ever so much, Susan. You take our thanks and our appreciation.
And your money.
I hope your old man enjoys his good community property. You know, $7,300. Thank you for being
here.
Thank
you. Bye-bye.
Eileen. Now you got $500. When you get back here, we're going to give you a shot at $5,000. We'll be back to do that in just a moment, but right now we have this for you.
Every great moment, every stylish look, every winning choice, every single day.
My mother's never going to talk to either one of us.
Good, good.
Goody, goody.
Primetime Buzz, weeknight starting at 8, only on Buzzer. Let's play.
Got $500. I've been calling this very kind lady Eileen Dear for the whole show, and she was nice enough not to correct me till now. It's Eileen Dyer. I am sorry that I didn't call you Dyer, dear. Anyway, you will always be a dear to me. Aww. For the moment is dire. Time to try for $5,000 in our triple play game. We asked our Child's Play kids to write brief definitions of simple words, and we took three a word, each written by a different child, A, B, or C. You have a total of 45 seconds to get six. Pay $100 if you get them all. And if you get them all, you win $500 a word. And if you get them all, $5,000. Ready?
I'm ready.
Bring in the clock. Now, the clock will not start counting down until you tell me where you want to start. Good luck. I hope you do it.
B.
Its fruit is long and yellow.
Banana.
Correct. A bar that you wash yourself with.
Soap. B.
Correct. Something you can see out of when you drive a car.
Windows.
C. Correct. Rock smashed into little grains.
Sand. B.
Correct. A food you eat, it looks like worms.
Spaghetti.
Correct.
C.
What you get when you pig out and eat a lot.
Four. B.
It's like someone who's as wide as a gigantic jelly bean.
Fat.
Fat is the right answer. You got all six. Congratulations. Eileen's going to be $5,500. You might be nervous, but you know how to count, all right, Eileen. Isn't that easy? Didn't you do well? Do you know how many seconds you had left?
I have no idea.
You had 16 seconds left on the
16?
Clock. Yes, that's how quickly you went. You went right down without a miss. You have $5,500, and you'll be back again and have a chance to defend that championship.
I'll be here.
You're more than welcome to be here.
All right.
You play this. He said she doesn't know if she's going to be able to sleep tonight. Listen, do whatever you want. Just come back alert and ready to go. We'll be back in a moment. Right now, we have a word for you. We've got to go out and raise money. Watch out.
Up next, using your body to form phrases can be hazardous, but a lot of fun on Body Language. Then it's Alphabet Soup on TV with Blockbusters. Stay tuned.
Eileen Dyer, $5,500 and a cordial invitation to return next time. You be here?
I'll be here.
I'll be here. If you like kids, you'll love Child's Play. I do hope you'll be here. Goodbye. Thanks.
Some departing contestants receive the Bissell Double Action Floor Sweeper. Snaps up dirt, litter off carpets and bare floors. Great for quick pickups between vacuuming from Bissell. Take a little work out of kitchen chores. The Oster Can Opener Citrus Juicer has power pierce and magnetic lid lifter. The cutting blade can be removed for easy cleaning, and the juicer makes pulp-free juice. A cookbook, a new unsalted 100% natural Adolph's tenderizer. Life is tough enough, so tender it with Adolph's original or new unsalted tenderizer. A spice rack from McCormick Chili, with the finest in spices and seasoning mixes for conventional and microwave ovens. Your house of flavor, McCormick Schilling. And all of the children appearing on Child's Play this week receive easy listening and functional this LCD AM FM stereo portable clock radio. Comes with accessory headset, push button controls from Tootsie Roll, the chocolatey candy with a delicious flavor. Or from Bushnell, one of the first names in sport optics, the Ensign wide angle Instafocus binoculars to get you closer to the action. Quality as far as the eye can see from Bushnell. And some of the schools providing production assistance will receive the Franklin Ace 1000. The sleekly designed personal computer features typewriter-style keyboard and 64K memory. Also includes a joystick game paddle connector. The Franklin Ace 1000. This is Gene Woods speaking for Child's Play. A Mark Goodson television production.
I'm the master reptile.